Today I'm going to show you how to work with Wavin's Q-Bic Plus Revit package and present its features. For this demonstration, I'm going to use the German package. Please bear in mind that localized Q-Bic Plus packages have slightly different built-in functionality and content. To create a Q-Bic Plus tank, it's good to start by inserting a new dedicated level. First, open any 2D side view, go to the Architecture ribbon and select the Level button. After insertion, its name and elevation can be modified. Along with the new level, Revit inserts three corresponding views. The floor plan is enough in this case so that the other two can be removed. The tank's floor plan requires a few adjustments. Its view template should be set to none, and in the view range, the top primary range should be set to unlimited. Now I can start designing the tank. Let's start with the infiltration unit array family. Select it from the mechanical equipment under the systems ribbon and place it where the tank's corner should be. Make an array starting from this single family. Use the array function from the modify ribbon and specify the desired number of units along the first axis. Set a starting point at the corner of the family and the step at a neighboring corner. The array should now be ungrouped. One more array should now be made along the second axis following the previous steps. Ungrouping the arrays allows you to select any unit array family and change it for one with a shaft. Each localized package contains a selection of different, fully compiled shafts. Each one contains all the elements that are necessary to build it. Adjust the shaft position by checking or unchecking the shaft right checkbox on the properties panel. For the next two steps, let's turn to the wireframe view mode as it will be easier to handle them. The tank needs some side connections, so select Connection Plate Array from Mechanical Equipment and place them where needed. Use the spacebar to rotate them and the snap points and lines to locate them in the correct place. Make sure to have the proper snapping options enabled in the project settings. The final step is to enclose the tank with the remaining side plates. Go to Mechanical Equipment once again and select Lateral Side Plate Array. Place its instances next to the sides of the tank to fill all the gaps. After that, adjust the side plate number via the number of columns parameter and extra end half plate checkbox. When finished, locate the families in the same way as previously done with the connection plates. Let's move to the 3D view. The tank is now ready to make some final adjustments. By selecting the whole tank, various parameters can now be set. These are the number of layers, the type of its bottom plates, closed or open, the destination of the tank. For infiltration or attenuation, which is one of the features that not every localized package has, this parameter influences the geotextile and foil quantities in the tank schedule. And finally, the tank's name, which will later be useful in the schedules. Bear in mind that making changes over large numbers of families at once takes some time to process. The total height of shaft families should be set separately, selecting the shafts and making the desired adjustments. It can also be set dynamically in a 2D side view. Also, the connection plate families should be adjusted separately. The connection size and type can be selected from a drop-down menu. The level and orientation of the connection plate can also be set. The depth of the tank's foundation can now easily be amended using the previously prepared level. To make inlets and outlets, make use of the generic pipe type included in the package. Bear in mind that the tank families will inform us about some invalid input by exclamation mark. For instance, when the set number of layers or top level of shafts results in pipe that is too short, or when the tank is set as attenuation with open bottom plates at once. The package is programmed to allow for tanks between 1 and 4 layers tall. Any attempt to go beyond these limits will result in an error. If your project requires more layers, please contact your local Wavin design support team. Now let's go to the schedules. The package is equipped in 3 of them. The first one is the geotextile, foil and volume schedule. If the tank has been named, each one will be listed separately. Its surfaces, net, geotextile and foil can be read from here along with its gross and net volume. The next schedule contains shaft elements and, again, every named tank has a separate section. The last schedule contains tank elements, which are outlined per tank. Let's zoom in to where the connection plate array is placed. The model layout suggests the lower side plates need to be cut as well as the side plate next to the connection plate. Please bear in mind that such a layout only results from using multiple array families and does not indicate that the side plate should be installed that way. In the schedule, every half side plate is added up, which means that these 4 halves stand up for 2 full side plates, both in the schedule and on the construction site. Thank you for watching. Make sure you watch the rest of the Wavin Tips and Tricks tutorials on our dedicated BIM channel.